taken pleasure in being in my body and using it that way. So it was just a joy when this came around and I got to got the opportunity to exercise that. And I love the muscularity of our show. I think it's good entertainment and it's fun to get on this roller coaster ride that is Reacher.
Yeah, and it's almost has got that sort of superhero type sort of feel to it in modern terms, in terms of realness. This has got a rogue guy. He does things his way. It's his way or the highway. He can be contained. He can be put on a leash. He doesn't take orders too well. He doesn't take advice too well, really. He's a man of mystery, but a man that's so stubborn or determined or set, he just believes he's right in everything he does, and that sort of cockiness sort of rubs off in the show. And tell me, are you the sort of Robin T's Batman? Are you the sort of that sort of sidekick? Are you the sort of the person that leads him on the straight and narrow, or tries to keep him on the straight and narrow?
I won't say I like to keep it on the straight and narrow, but Neely's role in the show is definitely to balance him. You know, I think she's the only person that can really get to him, that he will listen to in terms of what kind of decisions he's going to be making. And she will always have his back and she will always follow him into the fire, but she will just ask the question that no one else seems to be asking, or she will just flag the things that we all know are happening, or these are going to be the consequences of the decisions that you're going to make, just so we know. And and I think it's lovely to have that, you know, quality. In a, that's what you want in a best friend. You want someone who can check you. You want someone who can sort of hold a mirror up to you when you are about to make some questionable decisions. That's not to say that they won't have your back, you know. So I love that about Neely.
You're almost that sort of kryptonite in his armor, that sort of chunk in terms of that sort of soft spot, in terms of we get to see the humane type of his character, in terms of to see that human nature element. And tell me, Neely, is she a determined, feisty woman? Is she able to stand on her own 2 feet as well? Does she get hot and heavy and tick into the action when she's called upon?
Oh, definitely. I mean, as we see in the show, she doesn't pull any punches. You know, she's ready to go at a moment's notice and keeps it that way. And of course, her job as a PI also requires that of her. But I think she doesn't need to show anybody that, you know, she very much rests within herself. She does her thing when it's warranted or provoked. But I think naturally she's not someone who's going looking for trouble, but she will, you know, stand up to it if it finds her. And when you're with Reacher, it usually does.
Yeah. And I suppose for every sort of crime fighting sort of kick ass, he's only as good as his antagonist, that sort of arch caper, that sort of guy who's trying to plot his downfall the whole way. And to have a legendary actor like Robert Patrick, in terms of filling those sort of boots, we know him from Terminator. We know that he's in his element, he's in his grawl in terms of playing that sort of bad guy role. And as a young, aspiring actress, and I know you've been in a good bit of projects in the past, Maria, but to see Robert Patrick attached to a project that you're going to be in, is there still a bit of nervous excitement? Because I imagine that you can remember as a teenager probably watching Robert Patrick in some of his real top roles, and he's been in a lot of them, dare I say.
Yeah, he's great, and I think so well cast for the role. I think it's always exciting to work with people who are really talented, and he has such a magnanimous energy, you know, that he brings to this character that I think works so well, you know, for what that character needs to be. And it's just wonderful to be able to play against that. So I'm very excited that he is a part of this season of the show.
And Maria, we saw in season one, we saw the prison sort of element, the sort of being sort of framed for a crime he didn't commit. In terms of season two, I watched the trailer now, and it's almost feels like his band of brothers that he knows from his past are being picked off one by one. Is it a sort of a crusade in terms of to trying to undergo a plot and undiscover a plot? And is that the sort of running team? Is it the one main running team throughout season two, or are they multiple sort of spin-off sort of storylines that we see developing?
It's definitely about the family that is the 1/10. You know, our friends are being picked off, as you say, one by one, and it is us, you know, trying to figure out what happened to them, who did it, and pay them back, essentially, correct the damage that's been done. Or and I think it's really lovely to be able to have that dynamic all the way through the season. Of course, you know, there are things that happen through the season that I will not spoil in terms of where our characters go. But I think it is really exciting to be able to have that family dynamic and expand upon the world of the show and these characters and their backstory also, so that we know more about why Reacher is the way that he is, why Neely is the way that she is, and what makes them tick, and why they show up for each other the way that they do.
And as actors and actresses, are you very full on in terms of your own stunts for this show? We know it's an explosive type action sort of show. Dare I say it, or do you come most days home from shooting with bumps and bruises? Does it get sort
yes.
of fairly intense?
Yes, I am covered in bruises every single day of the show, but I love to do my own stunts, and I do take pride in doing so, and we work and we train incredibly hard in order to do so. I think everybody on the show gives their 100% into making it the best that it can be, specifically with the action, because it's such a key part of the show. So, you know, we go into rehearsals and we work out the choreography and we get it done. And I love that the stunt team, which we have on Reacher, is so incredible, and they have faith in us to be able to do these things ourselves. And so it's very exciting to be able to work with them to create these sequences so that I can do it myself, you know. Very exciting.
Maria, a second last question for you now. And before we came on air, you mentioned obviously one European talking to another European, Denmark to Ireland. I've been to Copenhagen myself. Quick flight, an hour and 45 minutes, I think an hour and 50 minutes from Dublin to Copenhagen. It's not long. I've made the trek there, going in that direction, heading east. Have you made the trek heading west in the opposite direction and touching down on the green isles of Ireland in the past?
I sure have. I love Ireland. I went many years ago. We flew into Dublin and then we took the train to the west coast, and I spent a week riding on horseback up and down the western coast of Ireland, point to point, unguided, with my mother, because she also rides horses. And we just spent this wonderful week exploring the incredible nature that Western Ireland has in Donegal and Sligo. And then we spend another week in a horse carriage riding around. And then we spend a last week by car exploring all these old castles. And I've been meaning to go back forever because I didn't feel like I got enough the first time. So the Green Isle definitely holds a very special place in my heart after that experience.
Yeah. And Maria, for the final 30 seconds now, I might turn it over to you, Maria Sten, and your character Needley, and she might enlighten all our audience, all our listeners, if they haven't seen the release so far, which was released on December the 15th, why they should catch up immediately. If they haven't seen season one, to box to fringe on season one to get themselves prepared for season two. And in terms of season two, if they've already seen season one and they're just about to tune in now for season two of Reacher and Channel Prime Video. Maria Sten, what's in store for them?
Action, big, bad, splashy action. Bring your popcorn and settle in for the ride, because it is one hell of a ride.
On that note, Maria Sten, from me, Jim Conlan, to you, we wish you all the best playing the character Frances Needley in Reacher season two, out now at the moment. No doubt many more seasons to come, but all that's left for me to say is, from me, Jim Conlan, to you, Maria Sten, stay safe, take care, and God bless. Goodbye, Maria.
Thank you so much. Goodbye.
Thank you.